Well, it's finally here. You know, we followed the design and output of this substation and really learned about the complex issues involved in building something like this. We've watched them clear the trees and build foundations. Now, after some really careful consideration and preparation, it's time to actually start delivering power to the surrounding communities. It's time for this substation to be powered on. But let's not get too ahead of ourselves here. This is 140 megawatts of power. That's a lot. You can't just come in here and just flip a switch and have it turn on. It's a very deliberate step-by-step process. So let's go talk to Jake, who will take us through that process of energizing the substation. There he is. Hey, Jake, how are you?
Oh, hey, Brian, how are you?
Good to see you. All right, we ready to go here? Is there a big switch? No.
Not really that simple. We got a little bit more we have to do.
What's the process?
We got a lot of testing to do. Once the control wiring's done, we got to test all the breakers, transformers, control wiring, and a lot of the control systems.
So how do you test it? You know, if I have a drill or something and I want to test it, I turn it on and it works. But you can't really do that here.
No, here, the first thing we do is we'll energize a small portion of the substation and we'll check phasing.
Phasing, what's that? It's very Star Trek sounding kind of thing.
A little bit. What it is you have the three wires that come in and leave the substation. You have to make sure those match up. So what the crew will do is they'll have metering devices and they'll check across open equipment, make sure everything matches up properly. If it doesn't, we'll change some things around and make sure it does.
Then we're ready to turn it on.
Then we have a lot of more testing to do in the control house.
All right. Well, can you take me there and go through it?
Sure. Let's go look.
Awesome. Whoa, this is cool. What is happening in here?
Well, I think Paul here, the manager of our design group, could explain things a little better than me.
Hey, Paul, nice to see you.
Good to see you, Brian.
So explain to me what exactly is going on in this house.
So this is the control house for our substation. From here, we can monitor and control everything in the yard. We have all of our systems for protection, metering, communication, security in here. And it's really the nerve center.
Is somebody here 24 hours a day, or is it?
Normally it's unmanned, but because we have remote monitoring control, we have 24/7 coverage remotely.
So when it is time to energize the yard, is it just coming through here and you start flipping switches? Does it happen from right here?
We can do all of the switching from these panels, and that's what we'll do when it's time to energize.
All right, well, I can help out if you need me to do something. Ready now?
No, not quite yet. We've got a couple more things to see. Let's let Paul get back to work.
All right, thanks.
Okay.
Thanks. All right, nice
thanks,
to meet
Brian.
You. All right, I'm excited. What's going to happen here now? Talk to me.
Well, we're about ready to turn the transformers on. Mm-hmm. You'll hear a small noise, but you have to listen really carefully because they're ultra low noise.
Mm-hmm. Any sparks, visuals, flashes?
Oh yeah, when we close the switch, you'll see a little arc when we energize the line and then a loud bang when we close the breaker.
Okay, so is there anything that we need to be aware of? I mean, obviously we should probably move away or?
Yeah, once that happens, it'll be an energized yard, qualified workers only, so we won't be allowed in the fence.
I miss being able to kind of walk around here, and it's been quite a journey since we came, you know, and cleared the land. So it's a moment of truth. Let's do it.
Let's go.
All right. All right, so we've gone from 50 megawatts to 140 megawatts, 10,000 square feet to 90,000 square feet, blueprints to actual real world structures. This substation is going to serve the communities in this area for years to come, and it's all thanks to the very hardworking individuals behind me. Thanks for coming along on the journey, and a very special thanks to Unitil.